Hello, I'm Paul Dajcik, founder of Elastic Steel, method of athletic conditioning. Today I'm going to talk a little bit about adductors release and adductors massage, and even a little bit about adductors and what they do. Now, a lot of people ask me, how can they get into the adductors? Little by little, people begin to understand that you need to release the muscle. The muscle is tight. The only thing that you do is stretch it. It may not always work. So if you are not looking for abduction, you're not looking to bring your leg away from the midline, you're looking for flexion, you're looking for extension, you're looking for rotation, believe it or not, your adductors play a very important role in that. They will restrict your extension, they will restrict your flexion, they will restrict your rotation of the hip. There are two issues with getting to the adductors when you're trying to release them. One issue is you get to them, for instance, with something like this, but when you do not feel enough pressure because there's a large surface area, okay? Problem number two, you would use something like this and you cannot get to them. If you did get to them, this is a smaller surface area, you will be able to isolate those specific spots, but you can't get to them. Now, for someone who has an issue with getting to the muscle, very often they don't have the flexibility to place the inner side on the floor, okay? People are like this, and there's space here, okay? There's space here. Once that space is there, you really cannot place your adductors there, because notice, if I take a ball and I place it here, it's not doing anything. I'm not putting the pressure on it, okay? So that's one issue, of course. Now, we're going to talk about getting around that issue. One thing I could do is place my hand under the ball, elevated this way. Okay, now that's not a large distance, but it works for some people. Okay, another thing I could do is use something that is larger than this and smaller than this. Okay, like a ball here. Okay, and I could place it that way. Now, for some people, the problem is not the object, but they can't find that location. So you have to move the ball up and down, side to side, till you find that specific location that you need. Okay, sometimes it's so small that you can't even hold on it, and you have to do little movement, okay? Little movement, and those little movements are gonna be felt a lot more than holding on, okay? That's another option. If you don't have something like this, okay? Ball, yoga block, okay? And now I feel it again. Okay. Now you can take a stick and try to massage it with a stick. Okay. Usually people are not going to feel it with a stick. Some people who are very, very tight might. Last but not least, hand pressure. Okay. You can lie down, place your fingers here and pull. Okay. Pull in. Like so. This also worked for some people, but you have to have stronger fingers and you have to know what you're doing. So this is just some of the options that you can do. By the way, there's going to be a contest to win the Splits and Flexibility DVD, the side split, the open front split, and the true front split. If you want to win it, just share this video and you automatically entered into that contest, and the winner is going to be announced on the 25th of May. Thank you for watching.